We recognize that the climate crisis is an existential threat. So a number of years ago, we made the commitment to achieve carbon neutrality by 2035. And by making this commitment to the new energy master plan, we are creating the conditions that will actually allow us to fulfill that earlier promise.
In order to make our campus more resilient, part of our plan concluded that we needed to put in our own backup generation plant on campus. That's a primary goal, and that work is already underway because it's so important for us to improve our electrical resiliency. Another important aspect of this plan is to replace our legacy steam system. We have a system that takes high pressure steam and moves it all around the campus underground in order to provide heat to the buildings. It provides steam for cooking in the dining facility, and that steam is generated from our steam plant, which you will know because of the large smokestack. And that steam is generated through the combustion of fossil fuels, mostly natural gas. And that system is old. It's more than 100 years old in some places, and it's very inefficient and it leaks. And instead of investing in a very old steam system that is last century's technology, we can replace it with new, highly efficient, zero carbon energy system on campus. In order for us to really maximize the energy efficiency of that system, we also need to make our campus buildings more energy efficient. Some of our newest buildings, like Singer Hall or Whittier Hall or PPR Apartments, are very energy efficient because they're using the latest technology in engineering efficiency and building envelope and window systems. But we have a lot of old buildings on this campus too. And through this process, we will also address all of our old buildings and make them much more energy efficient.
Swarthmore is committed as an educational institution to the greater good and to listening to the diverse voices that make up our community. And this Energy Master Plan is a part of that commitment, a significant part. It's going to both address core infrastructure needs. It's going to help us make sure that we are eliminating our contribution to greenhouse gas emissions. And it's going to provide for the energy future for our campus. It's important that we live into the commitments that we've made in how we operate our campus, so that as we're looking to how we can play a leadership role in contributing to a just, sustainable, and healthy future for our planet, we're also operating in a way that demonstrates that leadership and providing for a safe and reliable campus operations. And this Energy Master Plan does that. It will operate our campus and will demonstrate that it's possible for colleges to do that.
This is a very ambitious undertaking for the college. For us to undertake an effort like this that is going to span more than a decade and require significant investment from the institution puts us out in front of many institutions that are looking at ways to move to renewable sources for campus energy generation.
We must take decisive action now in order to ensure that we are leaving a healthy planet for future generations. And this is especially important to Swarthmore as an institution, which has long believed in the importance of being responsible stewards for the natural environment.